Hello student, today I am going to teach you about the graph coloring problem. This problem is related to the related and solved with the help of the backtracking technique. In graph coloring problem, we have to color the graph's vertices in such a way that no two adjacent vertices should be of same color. If I give you a graph and I give you a certain set of color, then you have to color that graph using that colors. You have to color that graph vertices in such a way that no two adjacent vertices should be of same color. For solving this problem, we shall use that one technique that is called the backtracking. In backtracking technique, what we do, we divide the problem into small number of sub problem. Each sub problem can have multiple options, and we take one, but here the difference is that the solutions of one subproblem affect the solutions of other subproblems. Means in backtracking, the problem is divided into sub problems, and first subproblem solutions affects the second, and so on. Means if you have divided the problem into n number of subproblems, then the subproblems one solution will affect the subproblem two solutions, and subproblem two solution will affect the subproblem three solutions, and likewise. So because initially the every subproblem will have multiple options, but by when you select certain options for problem one, then that will affect that whether that option would be taken or not. And if at certain point of situation you do not get any option to move forward, then from that position you move backward, and at that position you check out the other possibilities and other options, and if you find out any possibility, then you move further, and if you do not find out any possibility, then you again move backward. So the name backtracking is, then from the start root node you have many options. Among these options you select one problem, and after selecting that, the further decisions will be taken on the basis of the first decision. They are related to each other. They are not independent. The solution of the first subproblem, the option selected at the level 1 decide that what option you can take at the level 2. And similarly, level 2 decision will affect the decision at the level 3. It means you are not independent. The previous option that you have taken affects the further operation that you decide. Suppose, for example, if you have taken the admission into the science stream and you have selected the maths in an intermediate, then after that you have multiple options. You can do BSc, you can do engineering, you can prepare for simple graduations also using the art subject also. But once you want to go for the want to become the doctor, then you have to again study that subject, you have to backtrack, and you have to again complete your intermediate in bio stream, then only after that you can opt for the B pharma and medical or other streams. Okay, so this is the concept of backtracking, how this problem can be used to solve the graph learning problems. So I'm going to solve a problem, an actual trait. In this problem we create a space diagram corresponding to that graph in which we show every option, but due to the huge number of options I shall ignore some of the options, and I shall just show you the particular one choice of the sub problem, and I shall move further, because I cannot create every possible option on this limited space of board. So I shall take only one options, and after that I shall show that how the future option for the next sub problems, how the options are eliminated and how they affect the future selections. Okay, so I am just going to rub this one, and after that I am going to draw graphic diagram. Okay. Let's take a graph like this. This is the graph. Suppose this is the graph, and I in the nodes are suppose A, B, C, D, E, and F, right? And I have to color these graphs. I have to color these graphs using the three colors. The colors are red, blue, and green. I have to color this graph in such a way. I have to color this graph in such a way that the every two adjacent nodes should have different color. Node means if this one is red, then this cannot be red. Okay. If this one is blue, then this can't be blue. So here I shall draw a for the first option. If the root node, I have three options. Suppose I can color node A as I am coloring node A. For node A, I can make it red, blue, and green. I can color it red, blue, or green. I shall use the short form for the red. R means red, B means blue, and G means green. I shall use the shorthand representation. So here I shall use simple R for the first node. Suppose I start from this one and I color it as red. Okay, these are the other options. I am ignoring right now these options. After coloring this node, I can color this node B. This node is A node, right? After coloring this node, I have three options to color this node B. I can color it as red, blue, or green. But the initial condition was that no two adjacent nodes should have the same color. So this option where A is red and B is also red, A will be cancelled out because this is not satisfying the criteria. I can take either B as a blue or as a green. So in between these two, suppose as I have told you that because there are so many options and I have limited space, I cannot try to show every option here. So I am just taking one example. I am coloring the node B in blue color and I am moving further. I have colored it as a blue color. Suppose to make it simple, this one is green and this one is blue. Because I am not canceling that option, but I am taking this one. Suppose I color it as a green color. Green. Right? I have colored this node as green and I am trying the further options for it. After coloring node B, I am moving toward the node D. Again, red, blue, and green. But here, B is green, so D cannot be green. Of green color. B cannot be of green color because no two adjacent nodes should be of same color. After this, either I can color it as a red or blue. Suppose I color it, I am not ignoring that option, but the dotted line shows that these could be explored, but I am just exploring the one. I am moving towards the one possible solution. There may be multiple solutions for that, but I am moving towards the one solutions. And suppose I color it as a red. Right? After coloring it as a red, the next node is F. Right? The next node can be colored in three colors. red, blue and green. But red, red is not allowed. So this option, because red node can't be adjacent to red node, so this option will be eliminated. I can go for the two options, blue and green. I can go for the two options, either blue or green. So suppose I color it as a green one. Green and blue. I take the order as green and blue. Green and blue. Suppose I move for, yeah, I am not cancelling that option, but I am taking this option and I color it as a green pen. Right? So I am writing the node number series inside the box. F node E to clearly show the color of the node. D, and here this node is B. This node is C, right? And this node is A, right? Now I am suppose coloring it in green color. I am using the limited number of options. I am selecting the green only because I am trying to get the possible solution with minimum number of color combination. Whether it is possible to color the whole graph with just two colors, then that would be a better solution. So I am not using a new color until it is necessary. So I am just coloring it in a green color. After coloring it in green color, when I go for the node number E, then this node cannot be colored. Then three options, red, green and blue. But if I color it as a of red color, then this there would be two adjacent red. If I color it as red node, then red is not allowed, so this cannot be color of red color. If I color it as a green, two green is not allowed, right? Now the only option we are left with is the B. We must have to use the third color, that is the blue color, and I color it as of blue, right? So I color it as blue. After this, the last node of the graph is C node. The C node can be colored red, blue, green or blue, right? But if I color it in red color, then two red node would be adjacent, so this one will be cancelled. If I color it in blue color, green color, then two nodes will be of green color, so this option will be cancelled out. If I color it in blue, then again two blue color would be adjacent, so there is no option. We have reached to the space, we have reached to a point where we cannot move further, we have no extra color and we cannot color it like this. When this situation comes, when we start backtracking. What is backtracking? Backtracking means we moved in backward direction where there was an option and we did not consider. In backtracking, we moved for backward and moved to the point where we have left an option which was unattempted. So only till the point, there are many options which we have not covered, but we just moved to the point where we have an options and we have not covered that. But we shall move backward to this point, but all the options have been ruled out. Here the one option has not been considered, so at this point when F is of blue color, so now we shall eliminate this points back. After backtracking, the color would be eliminated and now we shall go for this option where the graph F node was of blue color, right? Where F was of blue color. Now when we move from F, the next node is E. So I am drawing it right left side. F node of blue color. Then three options for node number E. Either blue or red and green. Blue, it cannot be a blue color because no two blue, there should be no two nodes of same color. It can't be red also, because right, the only option left with this node is the of green color, right? It can only be of the green color. After coloring this node of green color, we should go for the next node, that is C, right? If I color it in the red color, green color or blue color. If I color it in the red, then those two node will be adjacent, so option cancelled. If I color it in green color, two nodes of the green color will be adjacent, so cancelled. If I color it as a blue, then this is the possible solution and we shall approve this one. So by this space diagram, we can show that this graph, this is only one solution. But I want to remind you that this is only one solution. There were more many options that we have not attempted yet. So there may be multiple solutions for the graph, and this is the systematic approach with help of which we can try and get all the possible solution for the problem. And we can also finally say that with confidence, if there is no solution, that we have tried all solutions or options and there is no possibility for that. So in this case we have got one solution, but there could be the multiple one. So in this case we can see that no two nodes are of same color. So this is the one possible solution, and this is called the graph coloring problem. So graph coloring problem is the one of the very common problem to solve the, so that is solved using the backtracking problem. This is the space diagram, and you need not to complete draw all the options in that exam. You just need to solve one simple example and one simple solution, and that will be considered that as a solution. Thank you.